The evolution of decentralized exchanges. While today's DEXes are largely feature-packed and intuitive to users, things have come a long way since their early days. In this video, we take a look at how the DEX landscape has evolved. Decentralized exchanges, or DEXes, are a staple in today's decentralized finance or DeFi landscape, allowing users to trade in a completely permissionless and peer-to-peer manner. These platforms have revolutionized the way that users trade cryptocurrencies. But while today's DEXes are largely feature-packed and intuitive to users, things have come a long way since their early days, 2016 to 2017, first generation DEXes. Cast your mind back to 2016 and you might remember the first generation decentralized exchanges. Platforms like IDEX, Ether Delta, and Fork Delta began their operations around this time. For the first time, they allowed users to trade cryptocurrencies in a peer-to-peer manner, reducing the need for OTC groups and minimizing the need for trust. But these first-generation platforms suffered from the same common set of problems: slow, clunky UX, limited liquidity, partially centralized order books. Despite being non-custodial, many first-generation DEXs weren't fully decentralized and could instead be considered hybrid platforms. And as a result, they were prone to regulatory attacks, and some platforms were forced to block IPs from specific regions and implement KYC and AML policies. But more problematic was their slow and clunky user interfaces, which usually required users to transfer their tokens to the smart contracts of the platform or create an account just to set their limit orders. The platforms themselves were often slow as well, making it difficult to trade efficiently. These pain points helped shape the next generation of DEXs known as automated market makers, or AMMs, and many first wave DEXs have since evolved to tackle these teething problems. 2018, the advent of the automated market maker. It wasn't until November of 2018 that the DEX space first began to pick up momentum with the advent of the first popular AMM known as Uniswap. The platform changed the way that people think about peer-to-peer trading by introducing the concept of decentralized liquidity pools and pricing curves. By allowing users to deposit their assets into two-sided liquidity pools that use a mathematical formula, typically the constant product formula, to determine the relative value of each asset, it essentially solved the liquidity problem. Uniswap also helped to price newer and more speculative assets efficiently, helping to fuel the Cambrian explosion of ERC-20 assets. The AMM model became so popular that it is now used by the vast majority of decentralized exchanges, while just a handful can be considered the order book DEXs. Today, practically every major DeFi-capable blockchain has its own AMM, or a range of AMMs, many of which can be considered Uniswap clones or forks. This includes the massively popular PancakeSwap DEX for BNB Chain, Spirit Swap for Phantom, or Pangolin for Avalanche. Nowadays, DEXs can be better described as DeFi hubs. Besides facilitating asset swaps, most typically have a range of additional features, including yield farms, decentralized lending services, and launch pads. They have also helped fuel a range of new yield-bearing opportunities, including decentralized lending pools like Euler and revenue-sharing permissionless liquidity pools, helping users better maximize their capital efficiency. 2021, platform-specific DEXs. The vast majority of current generation decentralized exchanges can be considered asset agnostic. They generally allow users to trade whichever assets they want, so long as the liquidity pool for that asset exists. But more recently, a new generation of platform-specific DEXs have appeared. These are usually purpose-built for a specific ecosystem, and they allow users within the ecosystem to trade a restricted range of assets. One of the first examples of a platform-specific DEX is Katana, an AMM built on Ronin Chain. The platform is designed specifically for Axie Infinity users, allowing users to trade the native assets of the Axie Infinity ecosystem, including SLP and AXS, as well as generic assets like Ronin or RON and USD Coin. XCAD Network, the YouTuber creator and fan engagement platform, is also working on a platform-specific DEX, but this time for creator tokens. The DEX will allow users to trade permissionlessly their favorite creator tokens against a range of stablecoins, forming a closed trading environment for XCAD users. Given that some independent dApps can clock in potentially millions of active users, platform-specific DEXs can rack up an impressive trading volume. Indeed, despite only catering to Axie Infinity players, the Katana DEX has frequently achieved $100 million plus dollars in daily trading volume and averages over $2 million a day, making it one of the 50 largest DEXs by trading volume. 2022, multi-chain decentralized exchanges. The vast majority of today's DEXs either operate on a single chain or an independent version of a dApp and is available on multiple chains with no cross-chain trading capabilities. But thanks to advanced advances in cross-chain technologies like bridges and atomic swaps, the first generation of cross-chain DEXes are now up and running. This includes the likes of Atlas DEX, Swappery, SushiXSwap, ThorSwap, and a handful of others. To date, most of these leverage a combination of bridges and decentralized liquidity pools to pull off cross-chain swaps, while other platforms aggregate liquidity from DEXes on different blockchains, again using bridges to move tokens between chains. As an interlopable ecosystem of blockchains, Cosmos also features a variety of cross-chain DEXes, such as Osmos and Crescent, but it should be noted that these are constrained to the Cosmos ecosystem. It cannot bridge assets from non-Cosmos SDK blockchains. A handful of atomic swap DEXes now exist, such as Atomics, but none have achieved widespread adoption. 2022 onwards, the future era. The DEX industry is priming with innovation and can be considered one of the fastest moving sectors in the DeFi space. In just 6 years, we have seen the advent of multiple generation of DEXes, with some of the more popular options now beginning to rival the usability, features, and liquidity of centralized platforms. The beginning of the next generation of DEXes is also taking shape. This includes the likes of PseudoSwap, which just launched the PseudoAMM, a DEX that changes the way that users buy and sell NFTs through the use of AMM-like bonding curves. And recently, a tokenized equity DEX, known as NASDEX, was also launched. This allows users to trade tokenized equities over the blockchain. Centralized bank digital currencies, or CBDCs, might also get the DEX treatment. Currently being explored by central banks in more than 100 regions worldwide, there's a good chance that a regulated CBDC DEX could be launched in the future, and a small chance that a permissionless DEX will be launched, since most CBDCs are likely to launch on permissioned blockchains, but this is likely several years away at the very least.